Testing.
Thank you.
Thank you. He watched my mother give me birth as I fought my way onto this earth. That man would rock me off to sleep, would mark my tears when I did weep. He watched me go from crawl to walk and smiled with pride when I learned to talk. That man taught me to ride a bike and even how to fly a kite. He taught me to know wrong from right, when to run and when to fight. That man was made of many parts, a teacher of life's skills and arts, full of love and full of care, with much to give and much to share. As I grew older, so did he, but that man was always there for me, his love unspoken but strong and clear. Of that I have no doubt or fear. Time passed, that man grew old and frail, no longer strong, but weak and pale. Memories are all that we have left of that man who was the best. It makes us proud, it makes me glad, to tell you that man, he was our dad. On behalf of Carolyn and Helen, their families, I offer a warm welcome to everyone as we gather to remember, to reflect, and to celebrate the life of Noel Peter Hayes, better known to you all as Peter. My name is Simon and I'm a bit of a last minute addition today, and along with Adrian and all of the staff from Parkside, we thank you for the privilege of being part of Peter's service. It's never easy to say goodbye to somebody that we love. When the time comes and we are faced with this part of life's journey, it can be difficult to accept. It could be said that Peter, at 92 years of age, had a full life and lived to a wonderful age. But for those closest to him, it doesn't make it any easier. His passing is very final. He was, and he always will be, your father, your grandfather, great-grandfather, and friend. Today, as we remember and reflect upon Peter's life, may the memories of him bring you comfort and hopefully a smile to your face. For Peter was a very quiet, private person, but at the same time he loved to socialise. He was known for his dry sense of humour and his enjoyment of a beer with his mates. He was an active person and he liked to keep busy. Being clever with his hands and a tinkerer, you could give him anything and he'd have a go at fixing it. Having lived through the Depression and war times, when things were not plentiful, Peter continued throughout his life not being wasteful and not throwing anything out. His reason being, it might be useful one day. The girls said that their dad kept everything from bread tags to corks and empty boxes and what seemed like 29,000 pairs of glasses. Peter was fiercely independent and yet always willing to help anyone who needed it. He didn't always have it easy, yet he never complained and just quietly got on with his life. Nothing gave him more pleasure than to be surrounded by his family, and although he was not one to show his emotions, his love was in everything he did for them. And so with that in mind, I'd like to invite grandson Matthew to come forward and share the eulogy.
Peter Hayes was born Noel Peter Hayes at Kingston Beach on 24th of December 1928, a Christmas present to parents Aubrey and Dorothy Hayes. Peter was never intended to be known as Noel. Peter's father was a master of handwriting and worked out that it was easier to sign NPH than PNH. Peter's father was a school headmaster, and Peter can remember living at Mount Roland, Sprent, Somerset, Stowport, and lastly Romaine, where his father retired before moving to Upper Burnie. Peter had two brothers, Eric and John, who both predeceased him. Peter's primary education was completed at Somerset and Stowport, followed by secondary education at Burnie High School, Stella Maris on Mount Street, and night school at the old Burnie High School, where he studied motor mechanics and accounting. While it was motor mechanics which was his hobby in his adolescent years, it was the accounting studies which was to form the basis of most of his working life. Peter commenced work as a clerk at Alex Osborne Proprietary Limited on the corner of Mount and Wilmot Streets in 1944. Peter left Osborne's in 1949 to take a new position of finance officer for Trans Australia Airlines. In 1950, Peter was wooed back to Osborne's to take over as manager from Max Cross, who was leaving to open a sports store in Devonport. It was around this time that Peter met and courted Mary Hay, who was working at Vic Clark's cycle and motorcycle shop. Peter and Mary married in 1952 and were proud parents of daughters Carolyn and Helen, proud grandparents of Matthew and Laura. About the time Peter married, he left Osborne's to take a position as a sales rep for Northwest Coast for a Melbourne company who were to open a warehouse in Burnie and appoint Peter as manager. After 5 years, the idea of opening the business in Burnie was no closer to fruition and in fact never happened. Peter then decided to go back to his accounting career and in 1958 accepted a position in the accounts department of the then Australian Titan Products Proprietary Limited, which later changed its name to Toxide Australia. Peter worked his way up through the ranks and held many senior positions with the company while not moving far from the accounts department. In 1973, Toxide decided to install a computer system and Peter was given the opportunity of supervising the installation and operation of equipment and software at Burnie and the mainland sales offices. This also gave Peter the opportunity to visit Toxide factories in England, France and Italy. Peter retired in 1989 after almost 32 years with the company. Peter was a late starter in the sports area. In the mid-1960s, he decided with a few friends to try his hand at golf and joined Burnie Golf Club, where wife Mary was already a member. Peter was to become a dedicated member of the club, was elected vice president approximately 2 years after joining, thereafter serving 3 years as president, followed by several years as secretary and treasurer. Peter was also a club delegate to the Northwest Division for many years. For his services to the club, Peter was awarded life membership in 1980, an award which he was very proud of. Peter would tell you that he was a pretty ordinary golfer with a peculiar swing, which sadly I've inherited, but he did manage to reduce his handicap to 13 at one stage. In the late 1970s, Peter decided to try his hand at lawn bowls and joined the South Burnie Bowls Club, where he enjoyed playing in the lowest division, alternating between bowls and golf. Again, Peter's management skills were to come to the fore. He was elected vice president shortly after joining the club and then followed several years as treasurer. Unfortunately, when Mary's health deteriorated in 2007, golf and bowls were not priorities in Peter's life, and Peter became pretty much a full-time carer for Mary. During this time, Peter was known to sneak every opportunity to have a few beers with his mates at the RSL club, where Mary also enjoyed many visits for meals with friends and an odd win on the pokies. Sadly, Mary passed away in September 2008. Peter is a proud big pop to Elijah, Charlotte and Grace, and will be greatly missed by each and every one of us. Rest in peace, Dad, Pop, Big Pop. You've earned it.
Thanks, Matthew. A couple of stories that Carolyn and Helen recounted the other day. Peter, in his later years, suffered with cellulitis in his legs and feet, causing numbness in those areas. One evening, they were out for tea at the Beach Hotel, having a meal, and Peter couldn't find his fork. They looked under the table, but it was nowhere to be found, so they eventually asked the waitress for another one. Later that night, after he'd arrived home, the girls got a call from their dad telling them that he'd found the fork. It was in his shoe. Another time, he lost his mobile phone and couldn't find it. He tried to ring it from the landline, and whatever room he went into in the house, he could hear the phone ringing, but he could not trace it. Carolyn told him that the phone must be on him. Peter said, no, it can't be. Not having any feeling in his feet, he later found it down the back of his slipper. And I'll continue on with some more tributes. And it says, there's an empty bed, an empty chair, an empty house. You have gone and everything seems empty. We know that you're in a better place, resting peacefully, and you have earned that right. It's just a shame it took you longer than you wanted. We were so lucky that you could remain at home where you were comfortable and could have your family around you. We felt helpless watching you fade away and wish that we could have done more to help you. But we know you're appreciative of everything that was being done for you. The family wish to thank the following people, and they hope that they haven't missed anyone. So firstly to Jason Beamish. Without your expertise, we could not have managed that at home. We will be forever grateful. To Dr. Ian Wild, for the care that you provided to Dad and your weekly home visits. And to Clinton Beamish, for spending a lot of time with Dad and taking him to the beach hotel for a drink or two, until Dad no longer had the strength or the will to go. Trips to the chemist for medication, taking meals down to him, and their many talks, which we are sure would have been amusing, as they were both pretty deaf. We thank you for keeping him company on the days that we couldn't be there. To his neighbours, Neville and Claire Townsend, who were so good to Dad and kept a close eye on him. To Alan Fulton, a long-time friend and ex-neighbour who was also there for Dad, and his help was much appreciated. Dad also became attached to his wonderful carers, and it was clear that they formed a lovely bond with him and also with us. A special mention to Sally, Tracy and Rachel from Freedom Home Care. Thank you from the bottom of our hearts for treating Dad with the dignity and respect that he deserved. You were amazing. There are many people who will miss Dad, and none more so than his family. Sleep peacefully, Dad. We'll miss you forever. We're even going to give you your wish to have Roll Out the Barrel played today for your final farewell, much to our despair. The only thing missing is the barrel. Rest in peace until we meet again. We're now going to pause for a moment and see Peter's life through the lens of a camera and watch a photo presentation. Time to tell you now. I'd like to share with you now a poem that's been written by granddaughter Laura. It said, "When your last breath came and you laid your eyes to rest, I hope you know we all loved you so. You were ready for what comes next. It may have seemed like we had you in our lives for a long while, but forever is never long enough to stop seeing your smile. I'll remember all the lollies you hid and the chocolate cupboard right up the top. I'll remember how your face lit up when my babies called you Big Pop. I hope you're back with Nan up there, and I hope you're both at peace. I know you'll both watch over us and help put our minds at ease. Today we cherish your memories. Life touched many people, and consequently you will have many stories to tell about shared experiences with him. Today is about sharing and remembering, and the family invite you to join them here following the service for refreshments. Saying goodbye is never easy, especially when it's for that final time. But there is something I'd like for you to think about. Love never dies. So when you are missing Peter, as you surely will, think about how much he loved you, how much he cared, and how much he would want you to be there for each other. The time has come for you to say goodbye to a dear father, grandfather, great-grandfather, and friend. We offer our thanks for his life. We thank him for his friendship, his respect of others, his dry sense of humour, his kind and generous nature, and his love and care of his family. Peter was a good man, and he leaves this world a better place for having been here. We thank him for the life that he has lived, and may our lives be enriched for having known him. For those of you who would like to, may you now join with me in saying the words of the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. I would now like to invite Peter's family to come forward and to place a rose on his coffin as a last act of giving to this man who has given so much. So we have come to the final part of our service, and I'd like to invite you to please stand if you are able. Peter, in grief of your death, but in gratitude for your life and for the privilege of sharing it with you, we say goodbye. To everything there is a season, a time for every purpose on earth, a time to be born, and a time to die, a time to mourn, and a time to rejoice. Noel Peter Hayes, we tenderly and reverently give your body to the purifying elements, grateful for the life that has been lived and for all that life has meant to you. We take comfort in knowing that you go to be with the loved ones that have gone before you, and we leave the memory of our beloved Peter in peace. With enduring love and respect, we bid him farewell. As you leave this place today, there is comfort in your love for each other and your memories. Share them freely, without reservation. Seek solace for your spirit and ask for peace of your hearts. Then hopefully one day soon, you'll look back on Peter's life without sadness, but you'll smile, remembering the special person that he was. Thank you. Now's it's time to run.